Hello everybody, today we are going to see our next point, that is RHS condition. Okay, before this we have seen some conditions. Okay, with the help of those conditions we are going to give proof for the RHS condition, theorem of RHS condition. Okay, so here statement is given: two right triangles are congruent if hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are respectively equal to the hypotenuse and one side of another triangle. Okay, so here what is given, see, once again figures are given here. See here, two right triangles, here triangles are given, triangle ABC and triangle DEF are a right angle triangle. Triangle ABC is right angle at B and triangle DEF is right angle at E. Okay, triangles are congruent if both the triangles are congruent when if the hypotenuse and one side of one triangle, if the hypotenuse, this is hypotenuse, hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are respectively are equal to the hypotenuse and one side, are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of the another triangle. Okay, so in this condition both the triangles are congruent, that we are going to prove. Okay, but directly we cannot use RHS condition here, understood? We have to give proof for RHS condition with the help of previous whatever we have learned conditions. With the help of those conditions we are going to prove both the triangles are congruent. Okay, but only what is given here, two right angle triangles are given. So I am taking here given triangle ABC and triangle DEF are right angle triangles. Okay, here angle ABC is equal to angle DEF is equal to 90 degree. Okay, angle B and angle E are 90 degree. Okay, then what is given, BC is equal to EF, this is given, and hypotenuse AC is equal to hypotenuse DF, AC and DF are equal. So this is, these things are given. Okay, and we have to prove that, and one side, what we have to prove, two right triangles are congruent, means to prove triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF, triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent, that we are going to prove now, understood? So in this condition directly we cannot use any criteria directly with the help of these figures, the figures which are given here, we cannot use any criteria. See here, two sides are given, but they own an angle is given. Okay, two sides and angle is given. So SSA, like that there is no any criteria, understood? SSA. So we need to do here some construction. Okay, we need to do here some construction. So construction I am going to do here. See here, we have to produce DE. We have to produce DE in such a way. DE we have to produce such a way. Whatever length of AB, the length of EG. This point I am taking here G. Okay, means length of AB and length of EG will be same, as well as angle ABC. Angle ABC is 90 degree, that only the same angle we have to do here, FEG 90 degree, understood? Angle B and angle FEG will be same, okay, this 90 degree. And then finally we need to join this, okay, this new construction we have done, so we can show with the help of dotted lines, understood? So what construction we have done, AB and EG, the length of AB and EG is same. That we have produced DE in such a way, length of EG and AB is equal, as same as FEG is equal to angle ABC. Means this angle ABC and FEG will be equal. Like that construction we have done here in second figure. Okay, in triangle DEF or in ABC also we can do. So here construction we need to mention. Okay, produce DE 2G, DE, produce DE 2G, such that DE is EG is equal to AB or AB is equal to EG. So this side and this side is same. Okay, so I am giving here three lines. Okay, so both sides are same. Understood? As well as that angle is same. So now angle, here we can mention angle FEG is equal to FEG is equal to angle ABC. Like that construction we need to do. Okay, and we have done that. So now we will think about these two triangles. In proof, we are going to think about triangle ABC and triangle FEG. We are going to think about both triangles. Okay, so now given over to prove over construction over. Okay, we have written here whatever given things are there. We have written here what actually they are asking in the question. Okay, so that is our target. According to this, we are going to think about solution and construction we have done. Okay, so now we will think about triangle ABC and triangle FEG. Okay, so now here proof. In triangle ABC and triangle FEG. Okay, triangle ABC and triangle FEG. See here, BC is equal to EF, that is given. BC and EF are equal, that is given thing. Then angle ABC is equal to FEG, that is we have constructed like that only. So by construction reason we can give. And next thing, AB is equal to EG, reason by construction. So by side, by SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so that we can write. So we have taken ABC and FEG. So I am taking here BC is equal to EF. Why? That is given. Okay, next, angle ABC is equal to angle FEG. Why? By construction. Okay, and third thing is AB is equal to EG. This is also by construction. So by side, both the triangles are congruent. So triangle ABC congruent triangle FEG by side, by SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so now here we have given triangle ABC and triangle FEG are congruent. Okay, so one fourth part of our answer is completed here. Okay, so now with the help of this, we can say if both this triangle ABC and triangle FEG are congruent, then we can say angle A and angle G are equal. Can we say by CPCT, angle A and angle G are equal? So that I am taking here. So angle A is equal to angle G. So this is, I am saying this is first one. As well as we can say AC is equal to GF. AC and GF are equal. Okay, so that I am saying here AC is equal to GF. This is, I am saying, second one. And this, for both reason will come CPCT. Triangles are congruent, so corresponding parts are congruent. So corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so reason we have given here. Okay, now we will think about the next part of our answer. Okay, so now we have given here triangle ABC and triangle ABC and triangle GF are congruent. Okay, as well as we have said here angle A is equal to angle G. Okay, then we said here AC is equal to FG. AC is equal to FG. Okay, so that AC is equal to FG, I am taking here. AC is equal to FG. AC is equal to FG. Okay, but what is given? AC is equal to DF. AC is equal to DF. Okay, this purposely I have taken here, not necessary to write again there, but I have taken this last statement here because with the reference of this, we are going to write our next steps. So AC is equal to GF. okay, by CPCT we said here. But what is given? AC, AC is equal to DF, that is given. AC is equal to DF, that is given. Okay, but AC is equal to FG, we have given here proof, understood. So this I am saying, this is second one I am taking here, second one again. AC is equal to FG, AC is equal to DF. So can I say here FG is equal to DF, FG, FG is equal to DF. Okay, so we can say here from second, and this suppose I will say this is third one. So from second and third, from second and third, if AC is equal to FG, AC is equal to DF, that is given. So FG is equal to DF, FG is equal to FG is equal to DF. So triangle DFG is a isosceles triangle. Triangle DFG is an isosceles triangle. So can I say here angle D is equal to angle G? Isosceles triangle, if these two sides are equal, then angles opposite of equal sides are always same. So with the help of this, I am saying here angle D is equal to angle G. Angle D equals to angle G. This is, I am saying, this is fourth one. Angle D and angle G are equal. These are the base angles. Okay, in isosceles triangle, base angles are always equal, or angles opposite of equal sides are same. So here reason we can give, angles opposite of equal sides. Okay, angle D equals to angle G. But what is given here? See, in triangle ABC and angle D and angle G are equal. Okay, but here we said angle A is equal to angle G. Angle A is equal to angle G. So this is, we have said here first one. So can I write here from one, angle A is equal to angle D, G, but G is equal to D. So I am saying here angle A is equal to angle D. Angle D is equal to angle G, angle A is equal to angle G. So I am, the both angles will be same. So angle A and angle D are equal. So I am saying here from 1 and 4th. Okay, angle A and angle D are equal. Okay, finally, what is our target? We are going to prove triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent. Okay, so now we got here angle A and angle D are equal. Now one more thing that is already given, angle B is equal to angle E. E means DEF. So I am taking that also, angle ABC is equal to angle DEF. DEF is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so that is given. This angle and this angle is 90 degree. See carefully, angle A and angle D are equal, angle B and angle E are equal in DEF. I am talking about DEF. Okay, now which is remaining? Angle C and angle F. Obviously both the angles will be same, angle C and angle F will be same. But how we can write that? That I am taking here, see, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Okay, we want angle A plus B. Okay, angle A is equal to angle G, angle A is equal to angle D. Angle A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degree. So angle A plus angle B is equal to what? 180 minus angle C. Angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 minus angle C. As well as for DEF, angle D plus angle E plus angle F is equal to 180 degree. So angle F is equal to 180 minus angle D plus angle E. 180 minus, sorry, here we need to, angle D plus angle E is equal to 180 minus angle F, the sum of these two. Okay, so now why I have shown you here, see carefully. Now we are going to do here angle A is equal to angle D, angle A is equal to angle D. Okay, angle B is equal to angle E. Okay, so now what we can do here, angle A plus B is equal to angle D plus E. Okay, angle A plus angle B, angle A plus B is equal to angle D plus E, angle D plus angle E. Okay, but what is A plus B? A plus B is equal to 180 minus angle C, 180 minus angle C, okay, is equal to D plus E means what? 180 minus angle F, 180 minus angle F, okay. This is just I have shown you, you can write directly here also, okay. So 180 minus angle C, 180 minus angle F, so both side 180 and minus sign will be cancelled. So finally what is going to remain? Angle C is equal to angle F, angle C and angle F are equal. So this is I am saying here fifth one, okay, angle C and angle F are equal. Now we have given proof this and this angle is equal, okay. Now we will think about triangle ABC and triangle DEF, okay. So now in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, AC is equal to DF, AC is equal to DF, why? It is given, AC and DF are equal, hypotenuse are equal, that is given. Then ACB angle or angle C is equal to angle F, we are talking about these two triangles, huh? Angle C is equal to angle F, why? From fifth, and next thing BC is equal to EF. BC is equal to EF. So this is BC is equal to EF also given. Okay. So now here side angle side by SAS both the triangles are congruent. So here now I am taking triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF by side angle side criteria, by SAS criteria. Understood? So, what is the conclusion at the end of this theorem? What we can say, if hypotenuse, if two right angle triangles are given and hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of another right angle triangle, then both the triangles are congruent under RHS criteria. Understood? Here we have given with the help of another criteria which we have learned, SAS we have used here, okay. So with the help of that we have given proof for the RHS criteria, okay. So see carefully, once again theorems are important, these theorems we are going to use in class 10th also. So see carefully, what was given? First we have done here construction, triangles were given, right angle triangles were given, we have done here construction, we have given proof this and this triangle congruent, okay. Then we have by CPCT we said here angle A and angle G is equal, okay. And then finally we have to think about triangle ABC and triangle DF, because both those triangles we are going to prove congruent. Understood? So here finally we said here angle A is equal to angle A and angle G are equal, okay. Then AC and FG are equal, okay, AC and FG are equal, but what was given? AC and DF are equal, so this is an isosceles triangle, base angles are equal, okay. If base angles are equal, A and G are equal, so G and D are equal, so A and D are equal, like that we have given here proof. So see carefully and solve this theorem in your notebook, okay. Okay, see here, our first problem which is depend on the RHS condition, that is in figure it is given that LM is equal to MN, LM is equal to MN, means these two sides are equal, this and this is equal, QM is equal to MR, QM and MR are equal, okay, ML perpendicular to PQ. ML perpendicular to PQ means it makes here 90 degree angle, okay, and MN perpendicular to PR, so this is 90 degree angle, okay. So see here example is very simple, there are two triangles, okay, MLQ and MNR, two triangles are given, both triangles are right angle triangles, okay, and QM is the hypotenuse of this first triangle and MR is the hypotenuse of second triangle, and that are equal. Also one side LM is equal to MN and both triangles are right angles. So this is the both the triangles, we can say they are congruent by RHS criterion. Okay, if both the triangles are congruent by RHS criterion, then we can say angle Q is equal to angle R by CPCT. Okay, both the triangles are congruent, then angle Q and angle R are equal. If both base angles are equal, then angles sides opposite of equal angles are same. Okay, so which side is there opposite of angle R? PQ, and opposite of angle Q, PR. PQ and PR are equal. So that only they are asking, prove that triangle PQ is equal, sorry, side PQ is equal to PR. Okay, so now see here, in triangle PQR, okay, again two sub triangles are given, that is in MLQ, in triangle MLQ and triangle MLQ and MNR, triangle MNR. Okay, what is given? Angle L is equal to angle N is equal to, both angles are same, 90 degree. Okay, second thing, QM is equal to RM, QM is equal to RM. Okay, this is given and this is hypotenuse are equal. Okay, third thing is given, LM is equal to NM, LM is equal to MN, both the things are given here. So here this is given, then we can say LM is equal, QM is equal to MR, this is given, and next LM is equal to MN. So this is also given, and that is side of the triangle. Okay, so this is enough information for RHS condition. Okay, so directly we can see now, triangle MLQ congruent triangle MNR by RHS condition. Okay, if both the triangles are congruent, this triangle MLQ and MNR are congruent by RHS condition, then we can say angle Q is equal to angle R, angle Q is equal to angle R by CPCT. Okay, if angle Q and angle R are equal, this angle and this angle is equal. Okay, so sides opposite of equal angles are same, so we can write directly PQ is equal to PR. Reason, sides opposite of equal angles. Okay, so this was the simple proof of the given example. Got it, everybody? Thank you.